The quiet room helps all of us learn.
How do you do it?
Well, each of us knows how to work quietly. That's very important.
It's amazing what our schools look like in the 1950s. We found teachers instructing classes of students in rows at desks. Paper and pencil dominated the learning tools. But take a look at today's environment. Technology is permeating our learning landscape. At Elizabeth Ford High School, we find a faculty of seasoned veteran teachers. Direct instruction was the de rigueur of pedagogy when they began their careers. Flash forward to the classroom in 2019. How has teaching changed to meet our new learner? How can technology be a useful part of the learning process? Over the past year, one group of daring teachers at the high school took that step to change instruction and to meet our learners. Here are their stories.
The Modern Teacher Platform is a professional development warehouse with focused individual tiles that classroom teachers work through at a personalized pace with guidance and coaching from their administrative coach. This specific research project focused on the district goal of architecting a lesson using effective pedagogy. The research team embedded pre- and post-survey tiles to quantify the effect that this professional development had on classroom instruction.
I prefer personalized only because I think, especially with technology, we're not all on the same level. And it's good that people are starting and they're new, but for those of us who've been implementing technology for several years, it's kind of difficult to sit through trainings learning things that we already know how to use in our classrooms. So it allows us, just like our students, to have, you know, personalized learning.
We have been able to take a great amount of time to reincorporate our lessons using the Apple products that Elizabeth Ford has been offered through the iPad Initiative and the Modern Teacher Assisted Learning. We've also had so many other opportunities to take these items, take the time that we need to make our lessons more centered on a student's needs, and then modify it if we need to help out additional students should they need remediation or if they need something in addition.
Through the ability to examine and look at a lot of different pedagogies, I have been able to better address the needs of my students individually. We've taken a look at constructivist as well as inquiry-based learning, and it seems to be benefiting all of the students in my classes.
It's made me learn a lot more in a short period of time, but whenever you get lazy, then sometimes you need a boost, and this has been one of the better boosts that you can have with, again, the iPads and the technology that we've been offered through the different things that the school district has, Modern Teacher and the Apple program. It has been a positive light on Elizabeth Ford rather than something mundane that you just keep doing every year over and over. So even though it's been a lot of work, it's been something that was a great challenge.
Results from the LTS indicate a positive shift in teacher perception with regards to technology integration after a year of the Modern Teacher framework integration.
The teachers who embarked on the journey last year have seen an increase in technology implementation within their classes. In exit interviews, they reported self-paced PD made it easier to devote full attention to learning. It successfully challenged complacency. There was an increase in student investment. It created a stronger base of teaching pedagogy to improve practice. They forged stronger relationships with administration. They formed a community of learners within the cohort. And they felt markedly more confident with using the technology provided to the students.